guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Binta, and if you're new here and like what you see, make sure you hit on the subscribe button and also like this video. Okay, so I hope you guys are ready for today's Mandinka lesson video, and you've already got your pens and papers or touchpad or whatever you want to jot down this lesson on. Okay, so today's video is going to be a part two of our last Mandinka lesson video, which is to name some vegetables in the Mandinka language. And today we're going to be learning a few more vegetables, and also I'm gonna teach you guys how to communicate with someone if you're wanting to buy it at the market. Okay, so yeah guys, stay tuned and watch the rest of the video. First one we're going to be learning today is how to say the name of squash, the vegetable squash in Mandinka language. So squash in Mandinka language is said as nje ngo, nje ngo. Basically it's together, but for pronunciation I'm just gonna say that nje ngo. So back home I used to think that nje ngo means pumpkin, because that is how we use call it in English, pumpkin. But when I came here it was different. So here the squash is what we call nje ngo, nje ngo. Okay, so yeah guys, number two, the next one we're going to be learning is how to say the vegetable okra. Okra, okra is something that we eat a lot in the Gambia. Like we put okra in a lot of meals, you know, like okra soup. We do even put it in stew sometimes, and we also put it in an appetizer called kucha. So yeah, but other than that we do also use it in a lot of our meals with rice. So the way we would say okra in Mandinka is kanjo, kanjo, kanjo. Kanjo means okra, and okra is kanjo. Okay, we love kanjo in Gambia, and when you go to Gambia you're going to see a lot of okra there. Okay, so the way, if you were to go to the market and you want to ask someone how much is this okra, so the way you would say that is nyin kanjo mu jeleti, nyin kanjo mu jeleti. That means how much is this okra, how much is this okra. Okay, that's how you say nyin kanjo mu jeleti, means how much is this okra. And if you were to send someone to the market to buy okra for you, then you would say ta kanjo sanye, ta kanjo sanye, ta kanjo sanye, means go buy me some okra, go buy me some okra, means ta kanjo sanye. Okay, so the next one we're going to be learning is how to say cucumbers in Mandinka, and they're kind of similar but a little different. And the way you would say cucumbers in Mandinka is kakumba, 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 means cucumbers. Okay, cucumbers is kakumba, so kakumba means cucumbers. Don't forget that we have a lot of cucumbers in the Gambia as well. So let's say you're about to send someone to the market to buy you some cucumbers, what you would say is ta kakumba sanye, ta kakumba sanye, ta kakumba sanye. So basically anytime you're sending someone to get you something, you would say ta, then you mention the name of the particular item you're saying, then you say sanye, ta, mention the items sanye, ta, mention the item sanye. That is how you would ask someone to go and buy you something from the market or from the shop. So yeah, so let me say you want someone to buy you what is it called again, peppers, because last week we learned how to say the name of peppers, which is kano, kano. So then you would say ta kano sanye. Ta kano sanye means go buy me some peppers. Okay, so the next vegetable we're going to be learning is how to say the name garden egg. Oh my goodness, I absolutely love garden egg, even though it can be bitter, but I don't know, I love it. I absolutely love it. Okay, and the way you would say garden egg in Mandinka is jato. Jato. Jato means garden egg. I love it. Like, I can't even explain how much I love that vegetable. I think I love all vegetables. I'm a vegetable eater. Because in Gambia, we cook a lot of vegetables. So every time you see our meals, maybe rice meals, you have to know that vegetables are always included there. And we do blend vegetables and then we throw some of them in the soup while it's cooking, just to enjoy it with the meal while we're eating. And if you guys don't know, the reason why we do that is that vegetables helps in digestion. Okay, if you're eating rice, rice doesn't digest very quickly, but if you have like tons of vegetables on your rice, then your digestion process will be like a lot faster than not having any vegetables in it. So if you're Gambian, you know vegetables is our number one on our meals. Okay. And the next one we are going to be learning is how to say chili peppers. Chili peppers. Yes, we did learn the fruit peppers, and then we did also learn regular peppers, how you just say peppers in general, which is kano. But today we're going to be learning chili peppers, and the way you would say chili peppers is kani mesengo. Kani mesengo. Kani mesengo. Kani means peppers and mesengo means slim peppers. So mesengo means slim and kani means kano. So basically it is slim peppers. Okay, means kani mesengo. That means chili peppers. And if you were to tell someone to bring you some chili peppers, then you would say kani mesengo na tinyenang. Kani mesengo na tinyenang. Okay, kani mesengo na tinyenang means bring me the chili peppers. Bring me the chili peppers means kani mesengo na tinyenang. Okay, na tinyenang is bring it for me. So yeah, and the next one we're going to be learning, which is going to be the last one, is how to say the vegetable potatoes. Now last week we learned potatoes, which is the sweet potatoes, and the way I said we would say that is potato, which is very very similar to you saying potatoes in English. But today we're going to be learning how to say the white potatoes, which is the regular potatoes. And the way we say the regular potatoes in Mandinka is pompitero. Pompitero. Pompitero means potatoes, which is the white potatoes. This is not the sweet potatoes. The sweet potatoes is said as potato, but the regular white potatoes is said as pompitero. Pompitero. Okay, and if you were to ask someone at the market how much is these potatoes, then you would say nying pompitero mujeleti. Nying pompitero mujeleti. Okay, and let's say you want someone to bring you some potatoes, then you say wo pompitero na tinyanang, means get me those potatoes. Get me those potatoes, or bring me those potatoes, means wo pompitero na tinyanang. Wo pompitero na tinyanang. Okay, so yeah, that is it for the fruits. today, which is the part two, and I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. And make sure you stay tuned for the next Mandinka lesson video. We're not gonna be doing fruits again. Next week we're going to be doing some basic Mandinka words that you might want to learn. So yeah guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you hit the subscribe button if you do, and do not forget to like this video, and I will definitely see you in my next one. Bye guys, I love you.